there's a new trend on Instagram where influencers is their platform to market businesses in exchange for money. So you pay them and then they market your business. And this is different from a partnership, because in this case, this trend, influencers don't have a relationship with the business. They just market the business on their platforms because they have the numbers. So I tried it out. Of course, I had to, just to see how it works. I'm going to share my experience, tell you whether it worked for me or it didn't, and also share some pointers, because, you know, even if they're influencers, even if they have very many followers, that doesn't mean that they are the right influencers for your business. So how do you figure out who's the right influencer for your business? Hi everyone, my name is Miriam. Welcome to my channel for weekly social media marketing and entrepreneurship tips, tricks and tools. If you're new here, thank you for choosing to watch my video today. If you're a regular, thank you for choosing to watch yet another video, and I hope the new ones and the regulars have subscribed. Let's get right into it. So I wanted to do this primarily for a video, and also to see whether it's an ad method that I can use for my businesses. So I started talking to a couple of influencers, and then in the process, one of them actually reached out. And you know, this is when they're starting the whole market day thing. So they told me they want my business to be part of it, and of course they gave me their fees and everything, and I agreed. Now before that, I had seen my friend had also worked with one of them, so I asked her for her reviews, and she told me she didn't really get a lot of traction. So I mean, she at least managed my expectations. So I paid. This one was actually charging $1,000 for 5 days. Now most of them will charge you about 1,000 to 1,500 Kenyan shillings for a day. So I was like, okay, that's really good, but my trust issues were screaming. So despite doing this, I still ran an ad, a Facebook ad, Instagram ad that same week. So I mean, day one, I didn't get a lot of followers. I got an inquiry, and I could tell it was from that particular ad that I ran on the influencer's page. Anyway, and I still continued. And now I need to say that this particular influencer was mentioning businesses among her Insta stories, which is a plus, and I will explain to you later. So it wasn't like a full market day, it was her Insta stories are mixed up with the ads, which I mean, to me that was a win situation, you know. Anyway, so at the end of the week, I can't really say I got any sales from them. I can't attribute a single sale to this influencer's page. I got a couple of followers, not as many as expected. I think I need to mention that this particular influencer has 900,000 plus followers. In fact, there are more than 950k followers. So I mean, you know, my expectations were, I mean, a bit high. But I didn't really get what I expected. I expected at least, even if it's a sale on one day, but it didn't work out. And I mean, I wasn't really hurt to be honest, because I somehow wasn't fully relying on this, because I also had an ad running on my end. So I was like, oh, it's okay, at least I've made a sale. But now you see, my business is a bit more established. So I can say, let me just do an experiment with 1,000 Kenyan shillings. But then not everyone is in a position to do that. There are very many new businesses that have come up, and even spending 1,000 bob on ads can be a bit on the higher end. So we are going to go through this, and I will help you avoid losing money or wasting money, as you may call it. And then you'll also realize maybe it wasn't really wasting money. So I'll share with you some pointers, things to look for. Don't go in blindly like I did. And to be very honest, I also intentionally went in blindly, because most of us do that. But I already know, like, if my business is to work with influencers, I already know the ones that I am a bit more guaranteed, you know, are going to give me some traction. So I'm going to share with you how you're going to do that. So don't go in blindly like I did and like majority of us did. And if you've tried this and it didn't work out for you, maybe when you listen to my pointers, you're going to get why it didn't work out for you. So the first thing is, look at the engagement of this particular influencer. If they say that they are going to post this on their Insta story, and this person only has like two Insta stories in a day, or they barely show up on their Insta story, that already means that they don't have a lot of engagement on Insta stories. And for sure, if they put your product on their Insta story because already they don't have a lot of engagement on Insta story, it's not going to do that well. I need to mention that this influencer that I was working with told me, you know, sent me a screenshot of the numbers and the views and everything. I mean, the numbers looked good. And with time, I came to gauge how this influencer was using her Insta story. And yeah, for sure, it really made sense why my business didn't really get a lot of traction on her story. So look at the engagement. You can also look at the number of followers this person has, yeah? And then you go to the posts and look at the likes and the comments. If the likes and comments are so minimal compared to the number of followers this person has, then I mean, the engagement already is low, so don't expect so much from this particular influencer. And you know, these are things they won't tell you, so don't just be fixated on, oh, they have very many followers, my page doesn't have all these followers. And then I know the assumption you guys have is, oh, if this person posts my item on their Insta story, 900,000 people are going to see. No, that's not how it works. The algorithm doesn't work that way. So please don't be fooled by the number. Look at the engagement. You can also go as far as looking at their followers, because there are people who have bots. So you can find that this person has 500k followers and probably half of them are bots. So of course now you're working with a lesser number. So please look at engagement. I've shared with you two very simple ways of doing it. Look at how they interact with people on Insta story, if they say they're going to market there. So are they even active on Insta stories? And also you, if you're an influencer and you want to market businesses on your Insta story, if you're not really active on Insta story, so your engagements for Insta story are probably low, your reach is low. So of course businesses are not going to do so well when you market them. So even, you know, maybe try getting more active on Insta story. And then the second one, of course, I've shared is look at their likes, look at their comments, and compare them to the number of followers. It doesn't have to be, if you have 500,000 followers, you get 500,000 likes and comments. No, but if you have 500,000 followers and you're getting hundreds of likes, like just maybe let's say 200 likes, you know, that's a bit on the lower side. So look at those things. The second one is look at this influencer and see whether their following comprises a large number of your target audience. So for example, if this influencer is in the food sector and you sell maybe jam or butter or whatever it is that's food related, that's the best influencer to work with, because people following that influencer are interested in food. And so if your product matches that, then you're guaranteed that at least your business is going to be made visible to people who are already interested in your product. So just don't just look at the numbers that this person has 400,000 followers and then this one has 30,000 followers. Then you leave the one for 30,000 and go for the one for 400,000 because of the numbers. Yet this other one has nothing to do with your business. So make sure that the majority of the followers of this particular influencer form your core target audience. That is what you want. So that way, your product being placed there, your business being placed on their Insta story means that it's speaking to your target audience and they're just going to fall on blind eyes. Even if they have less numbers, you have higher chances of doing better because, like I said, their audience already is interested in your kind of product. Something else, just because you didn't get sales during the ad does not mean that that particular ad didn't work. So if you paid your 1,000 bob and on that particular day you didn't get any sales through that influencer's platform, that doesn't mean it didn't work, because the people who probably took notice of your business, of your page, and saved it, and then later on they're going to convert. So conversion doesn't have to happen immediately. Sometimes it takes time, and that's why also it's very hard to gauge the success rate of these things, because you can't really tell whether they converted. I mean, I've seen a couple of influencers doing this, and it's only one who's actually been honest enough to share both the positive and negative feedback that she gets from business owners. So at least that one, when you get into it, you can tell. Maybe it will work, maybe it won't work. Most of them won't really tell you the negative side. So me, I'll tell you, just look for awareness more than conversion, maybe it's going to convert later. So don't assume that just because it didn't convert, it didn't work. It's very hard to measure these metrics. Find out your business positioning in the ad, especially on market days. Now remember, market days, these influencers have set aside that particular day to run ads continuously. So they're not posting anything else on their Insta stories, it's ads. Now imagine if they have 30 ads that they're running on that particular day. Are you going to tap till 30? Because even for your own friends, my own friends, if they have 30 things on their Insta story, please be sure that I'm not going to watch, I think, past 15. And not even that 15, I've really, really stretched. This one's for I'm bored, so let me watch. After 3, I'm tired. So ask these influencers what's going to be my positioning in this particular ad. So that if they have very many people, then please don't even bother. If they really have 30 people, may I urge you, just wait another day, wait it out. Now there are some who tell you, for you to be among the first 5, you have to pay a lot of money, and they know that because the reach continues decreasing and decreasing as the stories continue. The people who learn it up on the first one, they say, oh, it's market day, I'm not going to watch this person's stories the entire day. And personally, I've also done that. And then that also will tell you it's first come, first serve. So you'd rather even pay today for 4 weeks later. If that will mean that you're going to be among the first 3s, it doesn't hurt paying today, appearing 4 weeks later, than paying today so that you appear tomorrow and then you're number 35 and you're assured that very many people have not viewed that particular Insta story. So there's going to be less reach, less engagement by the time your story is being viewed by people. And this is even why influencers, other than market days, they'll tell you, we can also run your ad. If let's say they have market days on Thursdays, they'll tell you, we can run your ad on Tuesday, but some of them will even charge you 5 times what you're meant to pay on Thursday, on the actual market day. It's because they know on normal days their engagements are higher than they normally are on market days. Every influencer who does market days will tell you that market days have the least number of people viewing their stories. So that is where they even charge you more. So please make sure that your business is positioned in a place where you won't lose out, somewhere where even you know that if you were to view that story, you'd actually reach your business, and not at the far end where, I mean, because you see some of them, I don't want to call them greedy, but I don't see why you should post like 40 Insta stories, and you know very well that even you yourself, you cannot watch one person's 40 Insta stories. So the people who will even limit, I think I talked to one who said she only takes 10 in a day, and I found this being very sensible, because people are at least guaranteed to watch those 10 stories, even if it's not everyone who started from the first one to watch till the 10th one, but there's more eyeballs than 40. You can imagine the day when you open someone's Insta stories and then you just see very many, I call them TikToks. So you see very many TikToks, you know, you even get discouraged and just close it, yeah. And then you see it's ads, it's not even just a story or something that you're very keen on following up on. So yeah, make sure that your business positioning is good. If your business allows, I highly advise you, as you do market days, also run Facebook ads, because ads are guaranteed. If you run your ads well, you're somehow guaranteed that you're going to make sales. It's not a gamble like market days. So if your budget allows, please run Facebook ads as well, because these ones are targeted. So 100% sure the people that you've targeted are the ones who are going to see your ad, and you just don't target random people, right? You always target people who are interested in your business, in your product, in your service. So you have more chances of getting sales with Facebook ads. There's less gambling. So if you can, please run ads as well. Don't choose market days as a replacement for ads, unless it's a partnership. No, that's different. If you're doing a partnership with this influencer, that's different. But if it's market days, don't use them as a shortcut, or don't use them to replace ads. It won't really go that well for your business. The last thing is, just because it worked for one business doesn't mean that it's going to work for your business. So just because someone ran an ad with a particular influencer and it worked does not mean that your business is going to do well. Again, remember, you need to do your research before you settle for a particular influencer. find out if their core audience relates with your business, because I mean, after this, you don't want to get into it blindly. So do your research. Don't just look at their testimonials. I mean, do your research. So for example, if I'm selling, again, I'll use the example of food, maybe because I'm hungry. So if let's say, for example, this influencer primarily talks about food, and then there I am talking about my shoes or innerwear that I sell, I mean, and then there's also another influencer who talks about all things fashion. So if my friend did an ad with this one who talks about food and my friend is in the food sector, that doesn't mean that it's going to work for me. I'm better off working with this one who talks about fashion because that's the industry I'm in. So do your research, then just copy. Don't go to an influencer just because my friend said it worked for them, it's going to work for me. Let us learn to do our research. I've shown you very simple ways of finding out whether an influencer is fit for your business. I hope these tips are going to help you. I hope you're not going to get into this blindly. All the best in your businesses. If you're an influencer, thank you for using your platform to help people boost their businesses. That really means a lot, especially during this COVID period when many people have started their businesses. So anyway, new business owners, don't be really hard on them. I've taught you now how to do your research, so don't go after them saying, oh, it worked for this person, how come it didn't work for me? I have taught you how to avoid those mistakes. So please, take note of everything that I have said, do your research, and I really, really wish you all the best. I will see you here next month. Yeah, September is ending tomorrow, guys. It's October. October is here. So I will see you guys next month, which is next Tuesday. In the meantime, I hope your September was amazing. I hope your October will even be better, and may your dreams and goals come to pass. Bye.